May I suggest that some of you today have got, can't give the Father a Father's Day gift until you dealt with this old issue of bitterness. Some of you can't give the Heavenly Father anything until you deal with the resentment and bitterness and anger that you have in your life due to being deserted or abandoned or mistreated by an earthly father. And may I tell you, he may be dead and buried in the grave, but don't let a dead man keep you from living blessings. You got to present your body a living sacrifice. I'm going to preach this thing for Dewey. Holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Because I recognize that my forgiveness is predicated upon how I forgive somebody else. And I don't know about you, but ain't no man or woman alive that's more important than me not having connection with my earthly father. And I came today to say, all of you, let the bitterness go today. Let the anger go today. Let the resentment go today. Well, he do it, Smith, you don't know my dad. He was not there for me, and I can't stand him. He abandoned me. Well, maybe that was God's way of protecting you. Maybe God just used his seed to get you into the world, but didn't want you contaminated by his past, by his bad presence. So he kept him away from you in order to protect you. And I wish I had somebody who understood. And even though he wasn't there, you still made it. Even though he wasn't there, you still working. Even though he wasn't there, you got through school. Stop complaining about who was not there and give God praise about who was there, because he was there all the time. Matter of fact, the Bible said, he said, I will never leave you, nor would I forsake you. Somebody may be a little depressed this morning because your earthly father is not here. But there's one who's greater than your earthly father. Yeah, his sweep is from everlasting to everlasting. He sues, he rules and super rules. He's not in a grave. He is omnipresent, meaning he's everywhere at the same time. Unlike your daddy, when your daddy says, I'm coming by to get you. There's one greater than that. Because if God says, I'm coming by to get you, when he came to get you, he'll bump into himself because he was already there. And you all give him God praise. The time I didn't know he was there. He was there when I was smoking. He was there when I was playing. He was there when I could have lost my mind. You ought to give God praise, not because of what you lost, but because God was always there. And so if you're going to give God a good gift, first of all, you got to deal with your bitterness.